I am Brother Stephen Elabo, welcoming you to Deeper Life Bible Church, Charlottesville, United States, a place where the undiluted Word of God is being preached. You are about to listen to our General Superintendent, Pastor W.F. Kumoye, as he comes forth to share the mind of God with you and your family. I want you to be ready. Pick up your pen and your paper and jot down important messages as they will do you good. God bless you and remain blessed.
Malachi chapter 3, and we're looking at verse 1. Malachi chapter 3, verse 1, it says, "Behold, I will send my messenger." Here is the Lord talking to the children of Israel, and he's talking to the people of Judah, and he says, "Behold, I will send my messenger." Actually, the children of Israel or the people of Judah, they have been wondering. If you look at the last chapter, that is in chapter 2 and in verse 17, the last line there, and where is the God of judgment? They were confused in their lives. They saw the wicked prospering, and they saw the people that were righteous. It's like they were not claiming the inheritance, and things were not going on well for them. And then they were saying, where is the God of justice? Where is the God of judgment? And they were saying, it appears the wicked are doing good. That's why they said, if you look at the middle part of that verse, when ye say, everyone that doeth evil is good in the sight of the Lord. What did they mean by that? They were saying, the people that are doing evil, the people that are sinning, the people that are backsliding, the people that are worshiping their idols, it's like they're making it. They were looking at the peripheral things. They were looking at the superficial things. They were looking at the things that were visible. And they said, the people that were doing evil, they appear good in your sight. And then they went on to say, he delighteth also in them. He seems to be blessing them. They didn't realize that the goodness of God was to bring them to repentance. They didn't realize that it's a good God, a wonderful God, that makes his rain to come on the just and the unjust, and makes his sun to shine upon the just and the unjust. And so they were asking, where is the God of judgment? Now God comes in chapter 3, verse 1. He says, behold, I will send my messenger. And actually, I hope you understood, but I hope you understand, the name Malachi actually means my messenger. Think about that. And the Lord was saying, I am sending my messenger unto you. I'm sending Malachi to you. And Malachi will tell you what happened in the past, what you are doing now, and what is coming in the future. It goes beyond that, number 2. I will send my messenger. He also spoke about John the Baptist, because John the Baptist is referred to as the messenger of the Lord. I will send my messenger. Look at Matthew chapter 11. As you look at Matthew chapter 11, here we're looking at verse 10 and verse 11. Matthew chapter 11, and we're reading from verses 10 and 11. It says, for this is he of whom it is written, behold, I will send my messenger before thy face, which shall prepare thy way before thee. And where is the God of judgment? Where is the God of justice? Behold, I will send my messenger. Number 1, I'll send Malachi to you. He is my messenger. Number 2, I will send John the Baptist. And here is what is written. It says in this verse 10, that this is he of whom it was written, I'm sending my messenger. Verily, verse 11, I say unto you, among them which are born of women, there has not risen a greater than John the Baptist. Notwithstanding, this is wonderful for me. I said this one is wonderful for you. He that is least in the kingdom of heaven is greater than he. Thank God, God puts a great value upon your life. And he says, the least in the kingdom, even if you count yourself as the least in the kingdom, he says, you are greater than John the Baptist. Let's come to Mark chapter 1, and I'm reading from verses 2 and 3. In fulfillment of the promise of God that I will send my messenger, Mark chapter 1, verses 2 and 3, as it is written in the prophets. Which prophet? It's written in Malachi. As it is written in Malachi, behold, I send my messenger before thy face, which shall prepare thy way before thee. The voice of one crying in the wilderness, prepare ye the way of the Lord, make his path straight. And then as you come to Luke chapter 1, reading here from verse 76. Luke chapter 1, verse 76, Zechariah, the father of John the Baptist, prophesying and then speaking to the people when John the Baptist was born. And thou, child, shall be called the prophet of the highest, and thou shalt go before the face of the Lord to prepare his ways. That's according to what he had been told by the angel before John was born. John chapter 1. In John chapter 1, I'm reading from verses 6 and 7. It says, there was a man sent from God whose name was John. I pray that you'll be such a man. That you'll see, there was a man, there was a woman sent from God whose name was, tell him your name. And then it says, the same came for a witness to hear, to bear witness of the light, and that all men through him might believe. God will do wonders through your life. That as you become the messenger of the Lord yourself, and then the Spirit of God is upon you, and the power of the Lord is upon you, and everything you do for the Lord will be blessed of him and draw souls into the kingdom in Jesus' name. Well, we, you know, over here in our church, we say there are members, there are workers. And actually, there shouldn't have been any kind of difference between the member and the worker. It says, follow me, and I will make you complete it for me. I'll make you fishers of me. That means the moment you stand up and the moment you say, I'm going to belong to the Lord, I follow the Lord, I'm following the Lord, it says his goal for you is to be a fisher of men, is to make you a minister, is to make you a messenger. I'm going to ask you a question. Now you become a Christian for 2 years and 3 years and 5 years. Are you going to remain, let me use the word, an ordinary member? Coming in, going out, until you die. Until you die. And he said that his purpose of calling you is that he will make you his messenger. And the people are asking, where are the evangelists and where is the goodness of God? Where are the people that will help us? And they ask the question, where is the God of judgment and the God of justice and the God that will show us mercy? He said, I'll send my messenger to you. That community where you are living, he has sent you as a messenger. You will perform very well there in Jesus' name. Number one, if you come back to Malachi chapter 3. Number one, Malachi himself was a messenger, the messenger of the Lord. The name meant my messenger. Number two, it was also referring to John the Baptist. And then come back now to Malachi chapter 3 verse 1. It says, behold, I will send my messenger, and he shall prepare the way before me, and the Lord, look at this, and the Lord whom ye seek shall suddenly come to his temple. He's not talking about another person. He's talking about Jesus Christ. He's talking about the Lord. And he says, the Lord whom you are seeking, he will suddenly appear in his temple. And what does he refer to that? What does he say about that messenger? He says, even the messenger of the covenant. That's the Lord Jesus Christ. He refers to him as Lord. He said, my messenger, Malachi, my messenger, John the Baptist, and then another messenger now is the Lord whom you seek, who will suddenly appear in his temple. Even the messenger of the covenant whom ye delight in, behold, he shall come. Behold, he shall come. Behold, he shall come. The Lord is coming. I said, the Lord is coming, says the Lord of hosts. He's referred to as the messenger of the covenant, and is the Lord himself. Look at Psalm 110. I'm reading here from verse 1. Psalm 110. And we're reading from verse 1. Referring to the Lord Jesus Christ, that he is coming. He is Lord. He is God also. You remember, after Jesus rose from the dead, and then he came to his disciples, and he said, peace be unto you. Thomas was not there. And then 8 days after, 1 week after, Jesus Christ appeared to them again and said, Thomas, come here and look at my hand and look at my side and thrust your finger, thrust your hand in my side. And Thomas realized, this is Jesus. He died and then he was buried and he rose again. And Thomas bent down and worshipped him and said, my Lord and my God. And Jesus did not say, don't say, you know, when an angel bowed down, when John the Beloved, when he bowed down to an angel, the angel said, no, no, you can't do that because I'm just a man like yourself. But when Thomas said, my Lord and my God, Jesus didn't say, don't say that because he's Lord. You call me Master and Lord, and so I am. And so here we're reading in Psalm 110, and I'm reading verse 1. The Lord said unto my Lord. You know there are two Lords there. The Lord, that's the Heavenly Father, said unto my Lord, that's the Lord Jesus Christ, sit thou at my right hand until I make thine enemies thy footstool. And so that's the messenger of the covenant. And that is the one, is the mighty God. Look at Isaiah. Isaiah. I'm reading from chapter 9 and verse 6. Isaiah chapter 9 and verse 6. It says in Isaiah chapter 9 verse 6, for unto us a child is born. Who is that? Unto us a son is given. Who is that? And the government shall be upon his shoulder. Who is that? And his name shall be called Wonderful. Who is that? Counselor. Who is that? The Mighty God. Who is that? Jesus. And so this is the messenger of the covenant. He is the Lord. He says, the Lord whom you're expecting, whom you're waiting for, he will come. He's the mighty God, the everlasting Father, and the Prince of Peace. Of the increase of his government and peace, there shall be no end upon the throne of David and upon the kingdom, upon his kingdom, to order it and to establish it with judgment and with justice from henceforth, even forever. And the zeal of the Lord of hosts shall perform this. It will be done. Haggai chapter 2. Haggai chapter 2. Malachi has told us that messenger of the covenant, he is coming, and you're expecting him, and he will suddenly appear in his temple. Malachi chapter, Haggai chapter 2, and here we're reading from verse 7. It says in verse 7, and I will shake all nations, and the desire of all nations shall come. The desire of all nations shall come. That's the Lord Jesus Christ is coming again. I said, he's coming again. And then he goes on to say, and I will fill this house with glory, says the Lord of hosts. And so you come to Malachi now, chapter 3. And Malachi chapter 3 is telling us, behold, the Almighty God is promising and prophesying and saying, is declaring, I will send my messenger, and he shall prepare the way before me. The Lord, and the Lord whom ye seek shall suddenly come to his temple, even the messenger of the covenant whom ye delight in. Thank God, we delight in the Lord. You're born again, we delight in the Lord. You're seeking the kingdom of God first and his righteousness, you delight in the Lord. It says, behold, he shall come, says the Lord of hosts. Today, we're looking at this message, preparation for the messenger of the covenant. Preparation for the messenger of the covenant. Because the Lord says, I'm sending him and he's coming. And because I'm sending him, you need to receive him. And you need to prepare that he will be yours. There are 3 points we're talking about. Number one, Christ's revelation in his temple at his second coming. Christ's revelation is coming, is going to be revealed, and it's going to appear. It's going to come. Christ's revelation and in his temple at his second coming. Point number two, complete restoration of all tithes into his sanctuary. Complete restoration of all the tithes into his sanctuary. And then number three, continual remembrance of the triumphant in his service. I pray you'll be in his service. You see, there's a special remembrance and a special blessing for those who are serving the Lord. That's why the Lord is calling upon us. Don't be idle. Don't be left out. Make sure that you're one of the servants of the Lord and you're serving the Lord this capacity or that capacity, and the Lord will bless your service for the Lord in Jesus' name. Let's come to number one. What's your number one there? Wonderful. Christ's revelation in his temple at his second coming. Malachi chapter 3. Malachi chapter 3. And we're reading from verse 1. Malachi chapter 3 verse 1. Behold, I will send my messenger, and he shall prepare the way before me. And the Lord whom ye seek shall suddenly come to his temple, even the messenger of the covenant whom ye delight in. Behold, he shall come, shall assist the Lord of hosts. Look at verse 2. But who shall abide the day of his coming? And who shall stand when he appeareth? For he is like a refiner's fire, like the fuller's soap. Now you can tell that this is not referring to his first coming. When he came the first time, he came as a babe in the manger. He came, he was unto us, a child is born. He came as a child. But now you see, he's coming. And when he comes, he says, who shall abide the day of his coming? It's referring to his second coming. Look at verse 3. And he shall sit as a refiner and a purifier of silver. And he shall purify the sons of Levi and purge them as gold and as silver, that they may offer unto the Lord an offering in righteousness. Since when he comes, it's going to purify, it's going to purge, and it's going to sanctify the sons and the children of Levi. You know, he didn't do that the first time when he came. This is the second time. He's coming the second time. The messenger of the covenant, the Lord Jesus Christ, the Messiah himself. He'll purify, he'll purge, he'll sanctify. And then he says they'll be able to offer the sacrifice in righteousness. In verse 4, it says, then shall the offering of Judah and Jerusalem be pleasant unto the Lord, as in the days of old and as in former years. You remember when Christ came the first time, Jerusalem did not accept him. Judah did not accept him. Even when he told the disciples, ye shall receive power after the Holy Ghost has come upon you, and ye shall be witnesses unto me, both in Jerusalem and in Judea and in Samaria and to the uttermost part of the earth. Jerusalem did not fully receive, and Judah did not fully receive. If you know where they were imprisoned and where they rejected them, it was in Jerusalem. But when it comes the second time, Christ is coming again. I said, Christ is coming again. Then he says, the offering of Judah and the offering of Jerusalem shall be pleasant unto the Lord. Look at verse 5. And I will come near to you to judgment, and I will be a sweet witness against the sorcerers and against the adulterers and against the swearers and against those that oppress the hireling in his wages and the widow and the fatherless, and that turn aside the stranger.